Hello everyone, and welcome back to our series. In the previous video, we successfully installed a powerful 10 kilowatt AM transmitter and conducted a basic test without activating the amplification. In today's video, we'll be focusing on the installation of the antenna tuning unit, also known as the antenna tuner or ATU. This crucial component plays a significant role in optimizing the performance of our transmitter. In this video, we'll begin by connecting the antenna tuner with the transmitter and the broadcast tower. Next, we'll be conducting an impedance measurement and adjustment using a vector network analysis and fine-tune the coil turns for impedance matching. Finally, we'll have an interesting test lined up, the transmitter aging test, which will elevate the performance, stability and reliability of our transmitter over an extended period.
Zero.
Let's dive into the part 2 of our 10 kilowatt AM transmitter installation project. Step number 1, transmitter to ATU connection. The first step is to establish a connection between the 10 kilowatt AM transmitter and the antenna tuning unit using the 1 and 5/8 feeder cables. Similar to what was done in the AM transmitter room, attach the ISMT EIA flange connector to the input port of the antenna tuner unit. Ensure the connector is aligned correctly and tighten it securely to establish a reliable connection. When routing the cables, exercise caution and consider factors such as cable length, avoiding obstacles, and maintain appropriate separation from other components. Step number 2, ground system for ATU. The second step involves establishing a proper grounding system for the 10 kilowatt AM antenna tuning unit. This is crucial for two main reasons. Firstly, it ensures electrical safety by providing a safe path for electrical faults and excess energy to dissipate into the ground, protecting equipment, personnel, and nearby structures from harm caused by power surges or lightning strikes. Secondly, grounding helps minimize electromagnetic interference, which is also known as EMI, by providing a reference point for current flow, reducing the risk of signal distortion or interruption. Moreover, a proper ground connection maintains the stability and performance of the AM antenna tuning unit by offering a low resistance path for fault current and minimizing voltage potential differences. To establish the grounding system, connect the ground wire to the ground system, ensuring safe and efficient operation of 10 kilowatt AM antenna tuning unit. In broadcast systems, it is recommended to construct the grounding system prior to the superstructure and to reserve a certain length of ground wire at key equipment locations such as the transmitter end, antenna and antenna tuner. In this case, we ask our partners in Philippines to reserve approximately 4 meters of exposed copper strips from the grounding system. Furthermore, we requested a dedicated room for the AM transmitter and antenna tuner, which offers several advantages. Firstly, it allows better control of electromagnetic interference, ensuring optimal performance. The dedicated room enables proper temperature and climate control, minimizing fluctuations that could affect equipment operation. Additionally, it assists with noise reduction, efficient cable management, and simplifies maintenance and troubleshooting. Compliance with safety regulations is also achieved. Creating dedicated rooms improves performance, security, and maintains capabilities, making it a valuable aspect of installation projects involving antenna tuning units or transmitters. Step number 3, guide tower to ATU connection. The third step involves connecting the AM guide tower and antenna tuning unit using copper tubes for AM broadcast signal transmission. Traditionally, the antenna and tuner unit are directly connected through copper tubes. However, in this case, since the antenna tuner is in a separate room with an insulating board on the wall, we will divide this step into 3 parts, which are calculating the distance from the antenna to the wall, connecting the wall to the antenna tuner, and connecting the guide tower to the wall. Start by estimating the distance from the guide tower to the insulating board in the antenna tuner room. Cut the copper tube to appropriate length using suitable tubes. Leave a small gap between the ends connected to the antenna element and cut the copper tube along the center line. After cutting, flatten the two cut branches with a hammer as flat as possible, which will aid in connecting the antenna element. Choose a convenient location on the antenna oscillator for mounting. Carefully wrap the flattened copper tube branches around the antenna oscillator using pliers. Ensure that the copper tube branches are tightly wrapped around the antenna oscillator and use hoops for securing. Use 5 to 8 hoops depending on the coverage area. Make sure to cover the copper tube as much as possible and tighten the clamps with a screwdriver to ensure a firm connection between the copper tube and the antenna element. Next, connect the end of the copper tube that is attached to the antenna element to the insulating board on the wall of antenna tuning room. Find the other end of the copper tube and determine the appropriate location for screw attachment to the insulating board. Flatten the end with a hammer and drill a hole as close to the size of the screw as possible. Additionally, file away any sharp edges of the copper tube to prevent accidental injuries during equipment maintenance. Once completed, determine the appropriate length based on the total length of the copper tube and bend it as needed, approximately 70 to 90 degrees, and use nuts to secure it in place. Finally, connect the antenna tuner in the room to the copper tube and insulating board on the wall using a specific length of copper tube. Measure the distance between the antenna tuner and the wall insulating board, then cut the appropriate length of copper tube using suitable tools. As before, punch holes in both ends of the copper tube, fold it into the desired angle until it fits perfectly into the interface. Sand the edges and secure the connection with screws. Congratulations! You have now successfully completed the installation of the copper tube between the guide tower and the antenna tuning unit. Step number 4, VNA-based impedance adjustment for ATU. The fourth step is to utilize vector network analysis, which is also known as VNA, to test the impedance of the antenna tuning unit and make sure it can fine-tune the impedance of the AM antenna. This process ensures that the antenna is properly matched to the 10kW AM transmitter, minimizing VSWR and optimizing power transfer for maximum output power. I will divide this step into two parts, which are impedance measurement and adjustment, fine-tuning coil turns for impedance matching. To begin with, measure the impedance using a VNA or an antenna analyzer and compare it with the desired 50 ohms impedance. Based on this comparison, determine whether the impedance needs to be increased or decreased. To modify the impedance, adjust the number of coil turns on the variable inductor. Increasing the turns will raise the inductance, while decreasing them will reduce it. Start by making small incremental adjustments, usually one or two turns at a time. Measure the impedance after each adjustment to evaluate the impact using a VNA or antenna analyzer. The second part is fine-tuning coil turns for impedance matching. Continue this iterative process of adjusting the coil turns, making small changes, and measuring the impedance until the VNA measurements indicate a close match to the desired impedance. This fine-tuning may require several iterations of adjustment and measurement. By using VNAs to adjust impedance, we can achieve optimal performance in terms of power transfer and minimize any impedance mismatch between the antenna, transmitter, and feeder cable. Step number 5, aging test. The fifth and final step is to conduct the aging test on a 10kW AM transmitter, which is a crucial part of the entire installation process for the 10kW AM broadcast station.
Zero.
This includes important steps such as stability testing, stress testing, temperature cycling, performance evaluation, error monitoring, and lifetime assessment. Due to time constraints, we are only able to conduct a partial aging test. During this phase, we connected the transmitter to the power supply and gradually adjusted its power to 10kW. Thanks to the precision buttons and advanced RF parameter display in our 10kW AM transmitter, we were able to continuously fine-tune its working parameters. If you are interested in learning more about the standard aging tests for AM transmitters or other broadcast equipment, please leave a comment, and I will consider creating another special video on this topic. In this video part 2, we successfully attached the copper wiring from the AM guide tower to the antenna unit and conducted antenna impedance matching and the aging test for the AM transmitter. However, there are still many more details to be demonstrated and highlighted. I will include all the necessary and interesting details in the video description, so please make sure to check it out. In the upcoming video, I will showcase the main components of this 10 kW AM transmitter, explaining what they are and how they function. If you are curious about the inner structure of a cabinet AM transmitter, this will be a video you won't want to miss. Stay tuned for the next video, where we delve deeper in the structural design of the 10 kW AM transmitter. See you!